guys, Flabaliki here today, and welcome back to Let's Play Planet Coaster Hard Mode. I feel like the hard mode part really expired about episode 3 or something like that. And then we've kind of just been making bucket loads of money ever since. So that's good. I believe we do have a $1,000 reward, though, and that's really going to go a long way. So let's get that. Oh, God. let's ignore the challenges. I really don't care about those. So, in terms of the agenda, no idea what we did last time because I recorded that about 2 weeks ago because I took a week off and then I was traveling and I was... Anyway, it's been about 2 weeks. So I know we worked around here and this is starting to look pretty good. I don't want to keep trudging away on this because I think you get the idea, and I'll do more of that in upcoming live streams shortly now that I'm back at it. We're going to be definitely doing some more live streams on that and probably finish off this area as well. Apparently as well, because there was a bunch of comments from last time saying that there was a patch that fixed the absurd amounts of people going to the balloon store. So I guess we'll find out because we have it there. We can open up the other one now as well. Because obviously last time I recorded, when I recorded the last part, that was before the update had come out. So let's see what happens. You know what? Let's fix this. This has been broken forever with the terrain going through the ground of that store. I'm going to put that over there because this has been uneven forever. I think we need to actually get rid of the pathway. I think that was the problem. Because we had the pathway there, and then we have all this other stuff. Let's see if we can fix it. Because that's been something that's... Well, since we built this area, which was... I don't know how many parts ago that was. It was back when we were still semi-struggling. So, it was a while ago. Well, let's do that. That should be enough room to sort of work with. So, I'm hoping that this will just... Because it has kind of messed up the plaza, but I'm hoping we can kind of... Ignore those plants. We'll fix that ourselves in a minute. Alright, so let's... I mean, yeah, this will be all right, actually. Yeah, just putting it like this. It'll have to be... it'll be a bit different from before. Hang on. There. Come on. Connect. Yeah. Cool. All right, so if that goes there, let me move that bin onto the pathway. Maybe about there. We have those plants in there somewhere, too. If I can... Can I grab that? Building? No, that's a... No, I want this. Nope. Ah, there we go. Sweet. I was really worried that I wasn't going to be able to pick that up. I was really worried that is our new problem, that these are just going to be stuck in here. Floral creeper 2, beautiful. Cool. Alright, so now we don't, finally, after about 20 parts, don't have grass coming halfway through those stores. I say 20 parts because it's part 21, so it's probably the first part that happened. I don't know if we can do much around the back. Oh, actually, yeah, we can. We can bring it through. Cool. Alright, so that will just sort of at least blend it back in a bit. Now, that shouldn't come through the stores because I don't think it lets you put terrain through the stores anyway. Oh, we fixed it! After so long. Oh, doesn't that make you feel good? Just makes me feel good. Alright, so... Next on the agenda. Well, I mean, there's not a lot of small things on the agenda. Oh, look at this. I do like this, though. After being away from this save game for so long, I just come back. It looks cool. It does. I'm very happy with it. We do need a... because I know a lot of people are like, this isn't connected. I'm aware that it's not connected to anything. And yeah, the rating on it wasn't very good. I don't know. Did anyone have any suggestions on that? Probably, but... notification squad, where you at? Maybe I should refurbish some of my rides. That was actually a good suggestion too. We probably should, hey? Ooh, yeah. We'll go through the coasters first. We'll start doing some refurbishments. Right. That's also a good suggestion. The peak looks like the sorting hat from Harry Potter. Nice. Oh, wait, this peak over here? Nice! It totally does. I like that comment. The top comment, my favorite comment is, James, whenever he doesn't like something. This doesn't look so good. It must need rocks! Okay. I get that I use a lot of rocks. But honestly, tell me, does that not look awesome with rocks in there? Like, I mean, seriously, like, it looks really good. Right? Or is it just me? Maybe it's just me that things looks good. I don't know. Lots of notifications that I don't care about. Right, so we will eventually build out over this way. Highly suggested that we do like a kids Candyland kind of area. So a lot of gentle rides. We can use the candy canes that came in the sort of holiday update. And I think that's a good suggestion because we could easily chuck in a... We used to have the station over here, but I think we'll chuck the station... Oh, actually, it's a bit close to that one. Oh, it doesn't really matter. Probably check the station around there, or maybe even on the corner and redo that bit. So we could easily get a station in there. And that would probably work quite well. Yeah, I think that'll be good. But, over here. I was trying to see if there was any suggestions for this coaster to make it better, but I don't think there was. Oh, wait, here we go. Maybe you should color the orange coaster sci-fi silver and purple to give it more space. Oh, yeah, orange was not the final color, by the way. I actually did see a lot of comments on that being like, oh my god, the orange. It's just the default color that was on it. So he was, well, orange, silver and purple. Interesting, interesting. Let's give it the base coat of silver. And we might be able to highlight it with the purple. I might do the supports as black. Or maybe they should be, maybe they should be white, like pure white. Oh, actually that looks a bit... Oh, actually white supports doesn't look bad. I just think white supports probably are a little unrealistic just because they would, if they were like pure white, they would definitely just chip because they'd be like painted or something. And just get dirty. So that's, I think maybe gray for this. Yeah, let's just get gray as well. Maybe a little bit darker on them. That's a bit better. And then we'll change the track up. All right, so... we could like line maybe like the rails. We could make those purple. Oh, even that. Maybe the rails as well. Hang on, let's have a look. See what that looks like. So that one and that one? No, not that one. Whoops. That one. And what's... No, the first one. It must be the first one then. Yeah. So what if we did it as like just purple track highlight, and then like the base of the track is like the silver, and then the supports are also like the silver sort of aluminium looking thing. And then we got to get a building around this. You know what? We got to get rid of these pathways because... Oh, actually, maybe... We do have to swap these pathways because the queue will probably be on this side, which will make more sense anyway. So they'll get scanned on the way out to make sure they're not stealing anything. All right. So can we just convert that to a queue? Oh, that would be too easy, wouldn't it? That would be too easy. All right. Well, let's go here. So this is my queue. Well, hang on. I need the, All right, go to the right. Let's place the entrance first. Roughly in the middle, about there. That's where it snaps to the grid, so that's a good spot. And this one, yeah, probably that'll be fine. Cool, all right, so then connect the entrance to the path. Should be this guy here. And I'm thinking, what do we do over here? Oh, yeah, do we want a fast pass on the right as well? Maybe, I don't know how popular this will be, though. That's always the real question. It's like, is this actually going to be a popular ride or are people going to hate it? That's the question. Hang on. I need to make sure we absolutely leave enough room for the fast pass because that's always a little to try and get in. Let's get this down. Get down to the ground. Okay. Select grid. Unfortunately, it has removed that support, but I think that's okay. For some reason, it does not want to connect there, but whatever. Ooh, damn it. I don't want to get rid of that support. I was hoping we could sort of squeeze it in there. Squeeze it in! Okay, can you not join there? Alright, so this will come around like this. I guess the Fastpass will be able... If we have it sort of branch off from here, we could definitely have it come underneath and up. Maybe. I say definitely, but... It's probably a bit of an overstatement. Alright, now. Hold up. Let me put... This, I think we'll just make it a little bit wider just for the sake of this tunnel as well. Turn off the snap. About to there. Okay, so then, select grid. Go there. Now, does this look, how munted does this look? Is that too munted to have that corner on there? How come that one doesn't have a fence on it? I didn't change that option. Unless when I go select my grid, it has... No, this select by grid has a fence on it. I don't know why that one doesn't. Huh. Well, whatever. Actually, that's not too bad. About that, yeah, that's not too bad. I think that's workable. That's workable. All right, so over here. Now, back to 4 meters. Right about there. Oh, that looks good. That looks really, really good. Okay, select grid. I'm not quite sure why that just hasn't connected, to be honest. Oh, there we go. I'm also really not sure why that one doesn't have a fence on it. Railing on ground queue. That's probably why. Oh, there we go. Yeah, there we go. For some reason, it wasn't selected on that. I mean, the queue looks a bit weird. I think with some scenery, it'll be okay, though. So we do that. I'll worry about the exit in a second. Let's see if we can get the, fast pass put in, which is found somewhere on the ride. Operation? Where do you... Oh, here we go. Priority pass. Yeah, well, priority pass. Wait, this is the entrance. So this will be... Really? I was expecting it could go in the middle. But it goes there or there. Oh. and even when you put it there, it's like... kind of glitched. Damn it. Okay, let's... Alright, let's redo this. Alright, so if we go like this. Maybe just do that, because now it's in a few different segments, so maybe that will work a little bit nicer. Nope, that made absolute... In fact, that made it worse. Okay. Alright. It's one of those days where we're just going to be messing with the pathway till it works. Alright, hang on. Select, the grid. Go there. Go there first. Because it's kind of in line. That's not too bad. Deselect grid. Hang on. Ooh. That looks a bit weird. But if it lets me put one there on that corner, that'll be fine. Ooh, it does. Yes. Okay. That'll go there. Right, so that's where you'll enter the fast pass. The exit will be has to be just before... Nope. Oh, there we go. That'll do, I guess. Then we'll come down here and then we can go underneath. Yeah, okay. This will work. I think, maybe. Alright, turn snapping on. Down we go. Down, deeper and down. We'll stay above the ground here a little bit. Oh, please tell me it fits underneath. It's going to... if it's... Oh god, what's happening? Where am I? I've entered the Twilight Zone. I'll tell you what I've been rewatching lately. Because I always like to talk about TV shows that I'm watching. How can you not fit under there? Just go to the ground. Whatever, that's fine. But then that's like above the ground. It's kind of weird what's going on here. I've been rewatching Futurama lately, and it's so good. I absolutely love that show. And I was just, because it's not on Australian Netflix, and I was really upset, because it's on the US one. When I was in San Antonio, I was able to watch it. I was like, this is so good. And then I was like, all right. But we have them all on DVD. I mean, but who watches DVDs anymore? Am I right? And nobody watches DVDs anymore. All right, so it's a bit weird, but I think that'll work. I mean, it will work in terms of it looking good. I think it'll be okay, especially once we start detailing around it. Right, the pathway that we're using is this little number here. A snazzy number. So this needs to go, I guess, out and around. It's going to have to, like... Hang on. Let's go. Ooh, this is weird. Can I... I want it to be, like, exactly in the right spot. About there. Perfect! So then they'll get scanned. And go up 3. Is that the right height? No, actually, I think we're a bit higher. Alright, get rid of that bit. Okay, turn off snapping first of all. Actually, no, turn on snapping, but let's go down to like, maybe 45 or something. Length 2? No, turn off snapping. We'll eyeball it. Because I think something like that will be, that's okay. Especially when it has like a building around it. That's fine, yeah, okay. Ooh, that doesn't chop someone's head off, does it? No, but you could probably touch it. But that's fine. Okay, cool. All right, so that totally works now. Cloud Runner 3. We really got to go through and name all this stuff as well. This is something I was always really bad at in my old Roller Coaster Tycoon 3 series. If you've ever watched them. If you haven't, you should go back and watch them. Great series. Can absolutely recommend that you watch those. Got 150 videos on Roller Coaster Tycoon 3. Go check it out. Really good stuff. That reminds me. Make sure to follow me over on Twitter. haven't done that in a while. Yeah, you should do that though. You can click the link down below to find me on Twitter, Instagram, and all that kind of stuff. It's really good. I was never good at naming rides. I would always just not. Like, we'd start off well, and then we'd lose steam. But let's see how Cloud Runner goes. How old is this ride? It's been here for ages, but we haven't opened it. How do you find that? Isn't it in, is it not just here? Date opened. Oh, but where's like the date? I really want to know the date built and how long it's just sat there. Now, I'm really intrigued to see if this thing actually pulls any guests in. Because this coaster over here, this one's actually doing quite well. Actually, I guess as well, to be fair, we don't have much queue scenery. Oh, actually, 77% queue scenery is not bad. But obviously, it could use a bit more.
Right, let's get right into the building of the structure. So, while that's running, we'll see what the kind of crowd is that we pull. And so far, so good. And then we'll start building our basic structure around this. Building material is going to be the metal. Because I want this, the main station structure, to be indoors. So completely closed. Like, this is all sort of scaffolding. I think I'll keep the queue like a scaffolding kind of theme like we've been doing. Because I actually quite like it. Oh, it might be overkill, but we'll see. But like I've explained before, pretty much the first start of the coaster up until it like launches out is where we're going to have it all indoors. Actually, speaking of it all in... Oh, never mind. I'll do that later. I was going to get the doors in, but I guess I can slow down time now too. Yeah, it actually seems to be quite popular, so I'm quite happy with that. All right. Building material is going to be the metal. Grab this guy. Okay, so obviously going to make the grid size a bit smaller. Whoops, a bit smaller. There we go. Right, so I should probably color that side of the station too. I guess, yeah, that'll just go on the inside there. I don't need that filter. So these will just build up here. So we'll not worry about like the sort of details or anything of stuff. So I think we can fit some doors there as well, actually, around that, which is pretty cool. Now, the station's actually... they really need a quarter tile wall piece, or wall pieces. Hope they add that in, because it's actually quite annoying. But yeah, for now, we'll start off just by having the station enclosed. Because I plan on having the rest of it not so much. So up until... whoops. Like where the brakes are here. So we'll probably have some doors here somewhere. And I'm thinking maybe even another set of doors to the station there. Right, so then down over here, all of this section of the ride down here as well is going to be indoors. Not actually... oh, yeah, I was going to say, I'm not quite sure why they can't go there, but yeah, the coaster is quite wide, so it has to go fair way out. Out about here. All right, so they'll go about here. I'm just guessing where these are going for now. Of course, we can move all this stuff as needed. Actually, no, that's fine. So we'll go there. Just get a basic wall shape going on. What I might even do is, like, if we have the... we can have the outside of the structure... hang on, what does this need to be? About there. We can have the outside of the structure. No, I've kind of put this... move those. Outside of the structure as, like, a rectangle, but then even in, like, inside we could do, like, some... maybe some curved wall pieces, so it looks like it's, like, really tight and fits in quite well. Which I think could be quite cool. Alright, so get these guys in all the way down here. Now, how is this gonna fit? Oh, fits perfectly, actually. So that swoops under really, really nicely, actually. So it's going to go all the way along. I'm hoping that the door... I should probably get the... I'll get the doors out in just a second. So this is going to go all the way to the end, pretty much. And then it'll pop out there. Where are those coaster doors? Because I know we used them on the other guy. I think... are they scenery? I think they're scenery and animatronics. Props. Animatronics. So the sci-fi doors in particular... why don't these line up with the grid? Sci-fi doors in particular are probably the ones we want to go for. Can we... is it possible to get this to line up with... ooh. I think we're going to have some fun trying to get this to fit nicely, aren't we? Well, let's just go precise placement and see what we can do. I guess I'll chuck it right at the end here. Hang on, I'll wait till that closes as well, then I'm going to pause it and then we'll adjust it. Okay. Right, so currently it's not lined up properly. Because for some reason... there's going to be a better way to do this. I often think that I know very... There's a lot of really cool, like, hidden kind of, I guess, features in a way in this game that I don't really know. Like shortcuts and just things, ways to do things quicker. And I feel like there's got to be a better way to do this, but I don't know what it is. Now, we might even widen the walls here or something to make it look a little bit better, but we'll bring this down. Because that's about as high as it needs to be. That's not even in the middle. Is it? Well, the door certainly isn't. I'm trying to see what... because, yeah, the middle of the door is there. It's slightly off, but I thought it was... only very slightly off. Because if we line up there and there, I'm lining it up with these lines here in the track. Still a little bit. I don't think it's ever going to be 100%, but we can get it close. I think that's pretty close. I guess if I line it up with that here. Actually, you know what? Hang on. Let me bring it down, because then we can just... Yeah. This is better. Because then we can just put this in the middle of those two bippity-bops. That will be right in the middle. There. Oops, I think I moved it a little bit afterwards. I mean, it's really unnecessary to have it 100% precise, but we might as well. Like, while we're here, we might as well. Okay, so now I think that's pretty well centralized. So we move that up just so it's touching the top of the roof there. Cool. All right, so that will go there. Then I'm wondering how early we're going to have to open this with a trigger. Let's see. Triggers, edit triggers, add a trigger. Move that all the way down the track to about there, maybe? I don't know. I have no idea. That guy. So we can play it. It goes, whoop. That actually opens pretty slowly. So I think I'm probably going to want to move that a little further back. Put it back about there. All right, let's have a look. It might actually be worth getting that second coaster train, because at this point, it looks like it might be a good idea, because it takes a while to unload and then load. Yeah, you know what? It might... Well, hang on. Let's see if this runs properly. Okay, go away. Let's have a look. Oops, hang on. Slow down time, first of all. So I'll come through here. This will all be indoors. Like, this will be above the roof, so you won't see it. It'll be wonderful. We'll have to turn off those supports there as well, because it looks a bit stupid. All right, so then it's going to start zooming. And... Oh! You wouldn't want that door to fail on you, would you? It is open just in time as well. If that door failed on the launched section of a coaster, you would be absolutely... I guess realistically, you could just make it out of like a cloth or something, so it kind of looks like that. So if it didn't open for whatever reason, at least you wouldn't kill people. Though, if you're trying to kill people, then why not? That's what I say. Have a bit of fun. Have a laugh. Have a laugh, you know? Right, let's grab some of these. So these I want on the station as well. Now, I really just wish that these would snap, to be honest. I'm holding down F. Like, you can snap them to the wall pieces, but then it does that. And how is that useful to anybody? What if I go angle snap 45? That also doesn't help us. It really doesn't. Maybe if I go there. No, even the 30 degree. How is that useful? Okay, first of all, don't light a surface. Second of all, how is this useful that it's not lining up with anything? Right, eyeballing. Hang on. First of all, get up there. Actually, that looks like it's rotated pretty damn well. I think I kind of rotated that almost exactly right. Right, so this then. Does this... See, now over here, the door isn't wide enough, which is annoying. It's like, over here, it's too wide. Over here, the door isn't big enough. It's also not... Is that rotated properly? I mean, it's pretty close to being... it's definitely going over this way a bit more. So if we rotate it a little bit... Ooh. About there, maybe? And then shift over to the left a little. You know what? Hang on. Pause. There it is. And then bring it down. Bring it down now. Break it down. Break it down now. And then get that in the middle. I know this is like absolutely riveting content, but it's going to be good. I guess we can put the door above the... You know what? I like it sort of like in the track. Even though it doesn't make any sense, it looks better. Especially because it'll sort of line up at the roof. Wait. Is that rotated to the right? That's not even flat. All right, so I have changed it up a little bit. I'm going to open that up. There's a bunch of people that just got kicked off that ride too. They took so long to get out of that queue. Look, there they all are. I was going to add a second train as well, actually. I tried it out, but I realized because those are block brakes, the train kind of, it sits through the door. Like, the doors just close over the train because the trains just go straight through it. But we'll see how this goes. I'll show it to you. The frame rate as well is really... Really suffering in this park lately. Oh, here we go. Let me slow it down. So, the front doors kind of just work. Like, There you go. Well, I guess actually that's pretty good. But it's pretty close. I think it closes pretty close to the... the last section of it just gets out before those doors close. It was kind of hard to get that timing right. All right, so then this comes around here. Into the launch. Fwa, 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 fwa! And then it goes through. Doors open just in time as well. Fantastic. Is there any timings on those doors? I haven't actually looked at that. Surely there's a way you can be like, open door for 10 seconds or 2 seconds. I don't know. Maybe not. Right, so it's going up and down and through there and up over there. All right, I guess we can fast forward this bit. Frame rate absolutely drops and I speed things up too. All right, here we go. So coming through. Then this one should open. There it is. And that's... Oh, my... Oh, that just opened. I think I need to adjust the timing a little bit on that one. Hang on. So we got the trigger here. So I did do a delay of 3 seconds. I reckon 2.5 is probably where it needs to be. Half a second quicker. And that should be good. Because 2 seconds was... The problem with doing it 2 seconds, it was too soon because the doors would close before it got into the station. So it's kind of trying to balance it. I mean, we don't really need the second set of doors. Like, we don't need those. I guess I could get rid of them. I guess especially if we're going to do... Or we keep those ones, get rid of those ones, because we're going to have a second train. Which I think having a second train is probably a good idea. So maybe I'll do that, actually. Maybe we get rid of these doors. Because then that would allow us to... Also, I don't know what's happened, but... For some reason, cars per train is now a dollar value. But when I click on it, it says 0.1, but it's 0.08. Even though it's, you know, 8 cars. But I don't know what's happened there, but that's clearly a bug. Number of trains, you can apparently have 1.2. Whatever that means. It doesn't work, but you can apparently do that. So, I don't know. Something's bugged out in there. I don't know. Is that on all coasters, or is it just that one? I haven't actually looked. I just noticed that before, and I was like, no, it's all coasters. I don't know what they've done there. But anyway, let's not worry about that. Right, so test that. Or not. Is this gonna... Let me just close it, make sure everyone's off. Test. There you go. Cool. Wait, does that sit inside the door, or do I need to move... Oh, yeah, that door doesn't... Oh, yeah. No, maybe we... Yeah, because they'll sit there for about 20 minutes, which should be okay when we're loading and unloading passengers. Hang on, so where... It might be okay. But if it breaks... hang on. So when it sits there... Oh, yeah, it kind of sits halfway through the door. All right, well, hang on. We might be able to work with this. If we move this forward, obviously, to about there... Then... Okay, well, actually, if we move it as far forward as we can without, like, intersecting stuff... Then we go here. If we're lucky enough... If the door will trigger fast enough here, it won't, guaranteed. Like, if we put it there, maybe it will work. Oh, there it goes. That's too slow. It doesn't work. We will have to have the door... Oh, hang on. Hang on. Hold up. So it sits there. That's where the door needs to go then, essentially. instead of there. Alright, edit building. Move the door. It's gotta go here. That's all. That's all it is. Just go there. I'm not gonna line this one up with the track just because... It's on a curve. Also, hopefully that's not too close to the... We'll watch it as it comes in, but I think that should be okay. Alright, because it makes more sense having it sit inside rather than it getting cut off. Not working at all. Right, let's get that trigger again. Edit triggers. Trigger number 2. We'll go there. So just after those breaks should be fine. All right, let's test that. All right, let's have a look. So we'll just keep it sped up. So now at least it sits inside. Those doors open nicely. It'll sit there and wait. This will come all the way around. I think this really should be a block break there. So at least when it gets to that bit, we don't have to wait too long. All right, so here it comes. Trigger is here. Ooh. Okay. Oh! It's got the delay on it, doesn't it? Because that was the door that was delayed. Yeah, whoops. Damn it. That's why I didn't... Alright. I'll have to wait for that to go around again. Alright. Speed up time. Okay, there they get that one goes. It sits there for a while. That's fine. This is going to come all the way around the track. We're going to slow it down as it pulls into the station. Okay, so it opens. Does it make it in before the door closes? Yes, it does. Oh, I didn't actually look if it fit, though. That was the other thing we needed to check. I think it did. Watch it again. We'll have to watch it again. Tooth me goofins has been fixed or broken down. One of the two. One of the two. Don't know which one. All right, here we go. Okay, now, does it fit? Because it is not... Ooh. Yeah, it does. I mean, just don't stick your hand out. Although, I don't think you could reach that anyway. I think that's fine. Cool. Cool. All right, let's open that. That's good stuff. All right, let's go back to the structure. I think what we'll do is I'll have to schedule a live stream so we can just build this. Because, I mean, sure, we could build it in an episode, but I honestly don't think you guys want to sit here watching me build the whole thing. I just kind of want to get the basic idea. Because once I get the basic palette done here on YouTube, right, so we get the basic structure, you can sort of visualize what I'm thinking a little bit more, and then we make it come to life in a live stream. I think that's usually a good way to do it. But if it's not, let me know. If you want to see the whole thing here in real time in a Let's Play, let me know, because we can do that. Otherwise, we'll just live stream it, speed it up, etc., etc. Right, so this wall would come... It would keep going down here for a while, but we'd also have this part over here in the structure. So that would go over here somewhere. Oops. Let me build this properly. When I cut away to do the stupid doors, I was listening to some music, and that's why it's stuck in my head. About there somewhere. Yeah, that'll go like that. Obviously, we'll finish this off properly. That's like my catchphrase. I'm pretty sure that's the catchphrase of the series. Yeah, we'll get to it. We'll do that later. What we do need to definitely do, though. Alright, so I think for this whole sort of speed up run, this will be like enclosed like that. So you'll come around the corner, I'll be enclosed, and be like, fwa, 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 fwa. And it'll be really sweet. Is it? No, it's unpaused. Cool. I think what would be really cool as well is if we can make this like, well, it'll all be in shadow. We'll have like lights on the wall. Oh, we trigger the lights. It's like, as you go along. Fwa, 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 fwa. The lights will turn on as you speed up. I think that'd be cool. We'll have to do that. Right, what I do need to do, which is actually kind of annoying because I have to edit the bloody coaster now and close it, I realize is we do need to get rid of the supports on this section here. Really just this one in the middle. Yeah, just that one. So track supports off, because that's going to be a roof and it will look a bit weird. We can do our own supports of some sort, but I just didn't want them coming through the wall. And also this one on that ride right there. Oh, actually, that'll probably be okay because we'll probably cover that up with an interior wall. That one we need to get rid of as well. And some of these over here. So, see, I want that, just that bit there and that bit. Can I just do this bit? Track supports. There you go. That one's probably okay because it's kind of inside and we'll cover that up so you won't see that. I don't think there's any other really obvious ones that are sort of sticking through where they shouldn't be, so I think it's quite good. Yeah, I think that's good. So, basically now... Hang on, that was a new icon. Oh. They change... Oh. I assume that's just a banking icon, right? Change the icon. Interesting. Yeah, I have no idea what they updated in the patch, so I have no idea what's changed since then. Right. Now we have to test it again, which is kind of annoying. So we'll get that run. I just want to see if people are going to ride this. Also, this should have brought up our scenery a little bit, right? 83%! Yes! So good. What I also want to do is actually color that side of the station, which we haven't done yet. Cool. All right, so that's going around. Blup, blup. Good. All right, this is actually going to be really cool. So yeah, none of this will be inside. So we'll have like this central structure. It'll be a pretty big structure, but the coaster is going to be all going over and around it. Then out the front, I think... I don't want to go overboard and do like full scaffolding like we've done over here, but I think a little bit here and then maybe just like a roof or like a shade over some of the queue could look quite cool. And then just some sci-fi scenery and buildings, I think, would finish it off quite nicely. I think that's the current plan. So that can be open now. What are we charging for this? $10. I mean, not that it matters. $345,000. Speaking of which, how are we doing with everything? We've still got two $5,000 commercials running, which is fine. Research. Oh, we've got a bunch of research too. Sprint 500 coaster. We've got the werewolf coaster. And we've got the hellion ring. I can show you another ring if you'd like. All right, let's start researching the other stuff too. Might as well just keep working through these things. Is that, are we like almost done with all these? Is that why there was like nothing? Oh, that was 300. Oops. 3,000. Just max them out. Get them done. 1,500. We spent $135,000 on research. One new item's available. Well, I'll check it soon. Don't you worry. Oh, look, 34 notifications that I don't care about. Oh, we're only making 611 a month. Oh, there we go. 7,600. That's fine. All right. So, oh, actually, that was the other thing I need to start doing is refurbishing more rides. Do we need to refurbish Boulder Dash? Because this ride's always breaking down. Let's refurbish that ride. Let's also probably refurbish one of these. Oh, actually, that's fine. That's also pretty good. So, oh my, look at that frame rate. That's rough. Oh, yeah, you got to come to this station over here and fix that at some point, too. Most things are okay, because it looks like they're being tended to well by the mechanics. So I don't think some... I think some of these are actually okay. Like, most of these are looking pretty good. I mean, it's not bad. Because age-related issues that cause faster wear and tear. I guess it's how many times is it breaking down? Because that's just, like, if they've just repaired it, it will look good. It might be worth refurbishing some of these, though, I think. So I think we'll go through and do it anyway. I'm just going to do all the original rides. I think, did we recently do this coaster? I don't know, but I'm going to do it now anyway. So all these first rides here are being refurbished, except for that one. Refurbish that one. In generic land. Jamiroquai. All right, so these guys now... That actually works quite well. In terms of the amount of time it takes the coaster to go around, it takes them to unload and load the coaster. Because that just... Everyone only just got off. They did an inspection. Now they're all getting on. Now it's going, and that coaster's just pulled up. That's actually perfect timing. That's actually really, really good. The rating is a little bit lower, I think, because I have to wait now. But at the same time, I think it should... It might actually change as well. Because they're not really waiting at all. Yeah, there you go. It's gone up to 5. Boom. Because I don't have to wait, because it's actually evened out the amount of time it takes them to get on, load and unload. It's actually quite good. They have to wait there for like a fraction of a second, and then it goes, so it's actually spot on! Oh, minus 6,000 bucks, but that's because of the research. Because all the research we're doing. It's almost done, actually. So let me know your feedback on this little section here. I think that's going to be a good plan. So we'll work on that coming up. And then we're looking pretty good. Looking pretty solid for the sci-fi area. It won't get much bigger than this. We'll probably have to do something in here because it's a bit empty there. But that's probably about it. And then we can start moving over this way, finishing up the log flume. Start moving over that way. We've got to finish up the log flume first. Yeah, we'll get to it. We'll get to it. All right. Reveal research. Victory family. Ooh, I can go to the kitty land. Sweet. Research of... Oh, we got a new thing as well. Thrill ride. Let's get that. 1500. I just want to see what the new coaster is as well, because we've actually got a lot of coasters. Custom. How many? No, it's got a lot. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So 21 coasters we have. That's pretty good. Pretty good selection. Oh, we got to build a wooden coaster at some point too. Like a proper wood, because we got this one. That's not a wooden coaster. It's technically not. So we got to do that at some point. Maybe we could do... Oh, I guess we got to do a junior coaster in the kiddie land, right? So we can't do a wooden coaster there. We'll have to do it somewhere else. I don't know where, but maybe over there. At about 50 episodes time when we get over there. I just want to check out these, and then I'm going to end the episode here so I can get your feedback and we can move on. The Stingray Coaster. Sweet. And we've got the Iron Horse. Oh, okay. The transport ride. Cool, cool, cool. Another coaster. Sweet. All right, I'll start that. 3,000. Cool. Right. I'm going to leave this part here. So let me know. We did that little section there. We also finally fixed this guy over here, which is good. And it looks like the balloon stalls have been fixed too, which is great. But yeah, we'll probably do a live stream between now and the next part so we can get a little bit more progress done. But leave your comments down below. So, you know, before I go into the live stream, I can take that into account and we can work from there. And then this will look pretty awesome next time. We'll get a nice time lapse in. That's why we didn't have a time lapse this time, just because I've come back from a trip. I've gone on a break and all that kind of stuff. So we'll get back into doing the time lapses at the beginning. From the live stream, and that should be quite good. Thank you so much for watching, guys. I will see you next time, and have an awesome day.